There are many Christians who believe that the coming of Jesus is imminent in that he can come at any time, and we do not know when he is coming. He can come now or he can come tonight. Where did they get the idea that we do not know when Jesus is coming and that we may be taken by surprise at his coming? This idea came about as a result of the misinterpretation of some verses of scriptures. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, Paul says that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. The pre-trib argument is, since a thief never lets you know when he is coming, we likewise do not know when Jesus is coming. But when Paul says that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night, he doesn't mean that believers will be taken by surprise when Jesus comes, because he can come anytime. The coming of Jesus will only take the wicked by surprise. Destruction will come on them suddenly, and they will not escape. Paul uses the third person, them and they, to refer to those unbelievers who will be destroyed. They will not escape. In the next two verses, Paul clearly says that the day of the Lord or Christ's coming should not overtake us believers like a thief. Verse 4, but you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, so that the day would overtake you like a thief. So it is rather clear that the day of the Lord or Christ's coming does not come like a thief in the night for us believers. It only comes like a thief for them, the unbelievers, who will be destroyed. Why and how did Joseph Prince and pre-tribbers miss the simple, plain, and clear teaching of Scripture that Christ does not come as a thief to believers is simply astonishing. It is clear as daylight that Christ comes as a thief only to non-believers and carnal believers who are living like non-believers in the Church of Sardis. The next time when you hear a preacher preach that Christ can come anytime and overtake his church like a thief in the night, you might want to gently remind him that he is actually implying his entire congregation is unsaved. Or the situation might be that his congregation has grown so backslidden and lukewarm, like the Church of Sardis, that they now needed to be urgently warned. The truth is, true believers who are constantly watching will not be overtaken by Christ's coming like a thief. When the Lord Jesus comes, there will always be two groups of people. One group, unbelievers, will be in shock at the coming of Christ. The other, believers, will not be surprised, because Jesus had already taught believers in Matthew 24 about the four signs that must happen before his coming and before the post-trib rapture can happen. It is therefore not true that Jesus can come at any time and that we do not know the signs of his coming. Next, Revelation 16:15 says, behold, I am coming like a thief. Notice Jesus didn't say, I already came like a thief, but Jesus said, I am coming like a thief. By this point in the book of Revelation's chronology, Jesus coming like a thief is very near the end of the tribulation. As the battle of Armageddon in Revelation 16:16 occurs right when Christ returns as a thief. At this point, Jesus is saying that he is still yet to come as a thief. Revelation 16:15 clearly states Christ coming as a thief occurs only after the sixth bowl. It is located very late in the chronology of Revelation between the sixth and seventh bowls. The seventh bowl is the fall of Babylon and the coming of Christ at Armageddon. Why would Jesus be coming as a thief after six bowls of God's wrath are already poured out just before the seventh bowl at Armageddon? If he had already come as a thief about 7 years before they were poured out, as taught by Joseph Prince and the pre-tribbers. If pre-tribbers teach that Christ comes as a thief before the tribulation, which is 7 years before Armageddon, why would Jesus warn, "Behold, I come like a thief," just when Armageddon is about to begin? This clearly debunks the pre-trib rapture doctrine, which sees Christ coming as a thief, as a warning about not missing the pre-trib rapture 7 years before the battle of Armageddon. Here, Jesus is making it clear that he will only come as a thief after the sign of the sixth bowl occurs. So how can Joseph Prince and pre-tribbers teach that Christ's coming is imminent, that he can come anytime, and there are no signs that precede it? Hence, Joseph Prince's use of the thief to support his pre-trib teaching about the imminence of Christ's coming is not only groundless, but erroneous.